and welcome back. This has been a successful year after year, and part of the reason is because of the wonderful volunteers. Now, there are volunteers who have been here for a few years, and then there are volunteers who are here since day one. Hi there, George. You've been here for how many years?
18 years. I want to ask everybody to bring your food because people in Houston need it. We really do appreciate everybody bringing your can because we really do need it.
You haven't missed a single year. What made you decide that you want to do this every year?
Well, I work for a good company like Dillard's, and I got their employees to help me feed the hungry. And I am studying to be a young minister, and you know, ministers are helping people out, and that's what I'm trying to do is help everybody out. So I want the people in Houston, come on out and help us. We help you. We'll help you. Thank you.
And another person who was with George on that day one was this gentleman here, Kenny Ryman, who was how old then?
About 17.
17. And
you've been in high school.
And you've been coming here year in and year out.
Years in and out, a lot.
I know. You enjoy it, don't you?
Yes, I do. The rain, the cold, and everything else.
Is this probably
the
worst?
Camera people work so hard in the rain all the time.
I know. You got yourself a little plastic outfit. Everybody's decked out in plastic. But nonetheless, that's...
Kenny was just commenting on our show a couple of days ago, we had a couple that's a recipient of food here from the food bank. And it was a couple that was doing perfectly fine. Life was good. And then all of a sudden, a car accident, you know, medical bills, all that. Now they can't even afford food. And Kenny just said to me, you know, Deborah, if I won the lottery, I would
give
it all to them.
Yeah, to help them out.
So you're playing the lottery, right, Kenny?
Yes, playing the lottery.
It's a pretty soft way of getting into that. All right. Okay, but nonetheless, thank you for your help.
Yeah.
I mean, these guys have packed boxes in rain and the dark of night when they first start out to the wee hours.
You know what, Don, you've been here for the 18 years when it first started
right
as
here.
Well. What's the biggest change?
Story.
You've been standing right in the spot for the last 18 years. What's the biggest change you've seen over the years? You mentioned earlier that you've seen it grow and grow and grow.
Well, you know, we've made it more convenient, obviously, for viewers. It used to be this was the only place you could drop things off, and then we made 20 places, then 30, and now 48, and then the post offices and the police stations. And you wonder sometimes, well, you know, perhaps the turnout won't be as great in one location. But like I just mentioned over here, it seems like this crazy weather has brought more people out. I don't understand.
Yeah.
No, it has just grown. You know that. You've talked about
like
it
the
on
first
your show.
Year you collected, what, about 80,000 pounds of food, and last year close to a million?
Yeah, it's really something. And you just mentioned that couple that was on yesterday when we were down at the produce place.
Uh-huh.
I mean, how much more could happen to one group of people, one couple, than has happened to that couple? And I looked at that, and I said, and we were talking down there. We were all looking at the story you were talking about. And the guy, you know, somebody had died, and the back got broken, the
so
hospitalization.
They had funeral expenses, medical bills, everything. Totally unexpected. Their house burned down. Yeah. Totally unexpected. But it can happen to any one of us. That's the thing. None of us are immune to this. And as the saying goes, most everyone is about 3 paychecks away from being homeless.
Right. Sheriff Fryer said something that's interesting to me recently. She's one of the women of distinction this year for the Crohn's and Colitis Foundation. And in an interview with her, she said that one of the things she's noticed about doing news stories is that when you get out into the community, all of a sudden these stories suddenly have a face on them, a
yes.
real face. You meet that person. You feel that person as far as what they've been through. And I think these kinds of things pull that all together with people on television, volunteers, people that have a little clout. It all kind of comes together in one shot, and it does have an impact.
Sherry's absolutely right. One of the first stories I ever did in the business was showing up at a man's house where we brought all these toys and things for the family. It's like part of the Sheriff's Department program, and we brought all these toys and things and some food. Immediately, the kids blew right past the toys, which you think kids only think about toys, you know, around Christmas time. Went right past the toys, went straight for the food, and the father was in tears. And he said, thank you. It's a godsend. You have no idea. We haven't eaten in the last 2 days.
Right.
We've been hungry for the last 2 days.
And you know, here's the real kick. Most of the volunteers that walk in and not only give up their time, they always walk in with a bag of groceries.
Yeah.
And that's another thing. Say, oh, where can I put my stuff before I start working? You know, and that's amazing. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys.
Typify the whole event and have for the last 18 years.
Yeah. And let's just get it on record right now. Next year, you're 19. You'll be back?
19,
I'll be
19
back.
And 20.
I'll be back.
Yeah.
You'll keep on coming.
We got the millennium. We got to go with that.
So come back to 3310 Bissonnette and drop your food off. Just help somebody.
Or you could go to Ball High School and be with Wayne Dolcifino.
Yes, you can.
You know?